If you begin your grocery trip in the produce section, you're more likely to stock up on fresh fruits and vegetables. Here, you can find fresh fruits and vegetables, along with pre-packaged and pre-chopped vegetables and other small rotating meals. We know this might not be everyone's favorite place to start in the grocery store, but look at this, say an orange, and think of it as the source for all of your nutrient goodies in your diet. All of these have micronutrients, which are the vitamins and minerals that help keep your body working in tip-top shape. In-season produce is usually much fresher than something that's out of season, so it'll have more of those nutrients that we want to stock up on. As an added bonus, the surplus of it being in season usually means that it's easier on your wallet. If something that you want to buy is out of season, that's totally okay too to buy frozen and canned. It'll still contain the same amount of micronutrients. While walking around the grocery store, be sure to pick up a variety of different colored fruits and vegetables. By doing so, this guarantees that you'll be getting all of the different micronutrients in your profile. For example, orange and yellow fruits and vegetables like grapefruit contain vitamin C and vitamin A, while green fruits and vegetables like asparagus contain folate and calcium. Not only will you be getting a variety of colors and micronutrients in your diet if you get different types of vegetables, but you'll also be getting different textures and flavors too. When it comes to buying produce, there are some rules that we like to keep in mind. We like to call this list the Dirty Dozen and the Clean 15. The Dirty Dozen is a list of produce that is the most likely to contain trace amounts of pesticide. For this, you should try to buy organic. The list includes apples, spinach, strawberries, and cucumbers. The Clean 15 is a list of produce that is the least likely to contain trace amounts of pesticide. Examples of this are avocados, cabbage, onions, and mangoes. You should feel comfortable buying conventional instead of organic. Spinach is one of the Dirty Dozen, so you want to buy this one, organic. Now, I'm going to show you a couple tricks about selecting fruit that's ripe or not. For a pineapple, the coloring outside should be yellow and not green. If it's yellow, that means it's ripe. Another trick is that if you can easily pull out one of the stems, it's ripe. Next, I want to talk about selecting the perfect avocado depending on when you want to eat it. If you want to eat it in the next day or two, the skin should be darker, and if you press it, you should feel a little movement, but it shouldn't be so squishy that your thumb leaves an indent. If you're going to eat it in the next 3 or 7 days, then you should pick one that has a lighter green skin, and it should be firmer to the touch. If you want to speed up the ripening process, you can put it in a brown bag on the counter. When selecting melons and squash, you're going to look for similar things. They should be firm to the touch, and if you knock on them, there should be a hollow sound. If there's not a hollow sound, they're probably squishy inside and maybe overripe.